This is the MonDak Oilfield Review with host Jason Spies.
My name is Jason Spies, and this is the MonDak Oilfield Review, heard in the Crude Life Media Network. On today's episode, we talk with Tsering Ngudu, Senior Equity Analyst at Tocqueville Asset Management, about whether the energy industry should be looking at rig counts differently, whether we should be layering in some new information or asking the question if rig counts are enough anymore. In just a moment, Tsering Ngudu, Senior Equity Analyst with Tocqueville Asset Management, and the new age of oil and gas, right here on the MonDak Oilfield Review. Hey folks, I want to tell you about a world-class leadership summit happening in Fargo, North Dakota, January 24th through the 26th. Now, leadership matters more than most things, and when a leader gets better, everything around it gets better too. Hatch Coaching is changing the way in which leaders lead, which greatly impact their retention, job satisfaction, and basically the overall joy in everything that they do. Folks, you are going to want to be a part of the World-Class Leadership Summit happening in Fargo, North Dakota, January 24th to the 26th. For more information, check out coachingwithhatch.com. That's coachingwithhatch.com. Welcome back to the MonDak Oilfield Review, heard in the Crude Life Media Network. My name is Jason Spies. Up next, Tsering Ngudu, Senior Equity Analyst for Tocqueville Asset Management, about whether the energy industry should be looking at measuring rig counts differently in 2018.
That's clearly not the rig count, because it's really footage fracked. You know, is what you need to look at. That's, you know, that's exactly what you're producing, what you frack, and you know, with the laterals that have doubled, and then we're going 2 miles, sometimes 3 miles now in laterals. So it's the number of wells is not the key. It's really footage fracked. The question is, can the Bakken, sort of the U.S. is generally considered to the expectations right now overall is for the U.S. to grow, depending on commodity prices, of course, but you know, around a band of about 1 million barrels, okay, for the next 2-3 years. Broadly speaking, the Permian is expected to contribute 80% of that, about 80% of that. You know, so right now the expectations for the Bakken are not that high. You know, the expectations are, broadly speaking, flattish or up, you know, single digits. So the 2 million barrels that, which would represent a doubling, would be considered by investors, you know, depending on over the next 4 or 5 years, highly unlikely. I mean, the investors generally think that the Bakken is not as efficient a resource as a lot of what you have in the Permian. Of course, there's some of the areas of the Bakken, as you were pointing out, Jason, you know, is better than others.
Once again, that was Tsering Ngudu, Senior Equity Analyst with Tocqueville Asset Management, on whether we need to look at rig counts differently in 2018. To listen to the full-length interview with Tsering Ngudu, or to listen to other energy series, visit our website, thecrudelife.com. That's thecrudelife.com. The MonDak Oilfield Review is part of the Crude Life Media Network. Check us out on Facebook and Twitter. All of those social media links can be found at thecrudelife.com. From the staff at the MonDak Oilfield Review, my name is Jason Spies, asking you to be happy, be safe, and keep it turning to the right.